Good afternoon, everyone. Today we are going to be entertained by Mr. Sean Naughton. He is going to be presenting project number one from the Advanced Communication Manual entitled The Entertaining Speaker. The title of the project is entitled The Entertaining Speech. Clever. Thank you, Toastmasters. Now, in this speech, we are, as an audience, we just need to prepare ourselves to just listen and be entertained. This is a fun one. It should be very fun. We should pay a special attention to the structure of the presentation. So, you know, we can relax and just have fun, but also we want to make sure that it has an opening that captures our attention, that this story or whatever, you know, Sean chooses to present, you know, keeps us entertained throughout, and that it has a really strong close. And with that, I would like to bring up Sean Naughton with The Road to Hana. The Road to Hana, Sean Naughton.
Imagine yourself in front of a beautiful, crystal clear, cool pool of water, looking up at a 100-foot waterfall cascading down to you. Well, that's the picture we saw in the brochure when we were getting ready to go to Maui, my wife and I. And so I'm going to tell you a story of how our adventure on how we actually got to be able to see that. It's called the Makawai Waterfalls. And it is in a kind of a southwestern part of Maui in Hawaii. Fellow Toastmasters, honored guests, I want to tell you my story. So I'm going to continue with that. Well, in order to get there, we stayed in a little town in Maui, kind of up on the volcano. And in Hawaii, you really don't need a lot of places to stay. We stayed at a friend's house. It was basically a shack. You can actually see their slots outside of her little house, this little shack. And all you really needed there was a roof because it rains every now and then. The clouds just kind of travel in circles around the island. And you get a little rainfall for about 10 minutes and it goes away. You get sunshine. And we decided we'd done all the touristy things and we heard we had to take the road to Hana to see the waterfall. And on the way, there's also, it's called the Seven Sacred Pools. So we thought, this sounds really cool. So we got in our little rental car, this little compact thing, and we started down the road to Hana. Well, the road to Hana is quite an adventure in itself. This is a little one-lane highway that weaves along the cliffs around southwestern side of the island. And literally, we're in our little car, you can look over and see the edges. And then you get to these bridges. And since it's one lane, you kind of had to, the bridges were one lane, the rest of the road was two lanes. So you get to the bridges, and you had to look and make sure nobody was coming before you cruise across the bridge, because it's one lane. And sheer cliff to the right of you. So this is just a windy, super windy up and down road. And you can get a little nauseous. I know my wife, by the time we got there, we both felt a little nauseous. And getting out of the car and breathing the nice fresh air in this beautiful green lush jungle in Hawaii made it worth the nausea. And we decided to stop there and have a nice little picnic lunch before we adventured up the trail. So we got to the mouth of the trail. And you start seeing there's a little river coming down. And as you walk up the trail, you start seeing these pools of water. And then they call the Seven Sacred Pools of Water. And these are just beautiful, crystal clear pools of water, blue. We went swimming in one of them and it just felt like mineral water. You can almost feel yourself floating in the water. It's just such a great feeling. Never had anything like that. I think it's the minerals from the lava rock as it comes down that causes the sensation that you feel when you're in this water. And those were beautiful in themselves. And then we got to the top of those pools and saw a little waterfall. And that little waterfall was it was amazing. I mean, that wasn't even the big waterfall yet. So getting to that one, that's the pool we swam in. And it was just so beautiful standing and swimming in that waterfall or in that pool and having the waterfall cascade on you. not like going to the water park here and having the waterfall, the fake waterfalls cascade. No, this was just, this was something out of the movies, really, because you have the lush jungle around you and nobody around, just my wife and I. And then we hiked up a little further, and we got to this huge banyan tree. Does anybody know what a banyan tree is? They're the big trees that the branches actually grow out, and then little branches grow down into the ground. So it's almost like a big cage. And this thing, this, I think the tree was probably as wide as this room, the base of it. And then it's just called this giant banyan tree in the middle of the trail. It's amazing. And all of the arms going everywhere, and it's almost like you'd have to go through almost like a jail to get through it because of all the tree branches that come down. That was pretty amazing. We hung out there for a while and took a little rest. And then our next step was, as we went up the trail, we got to this bamboo forest. And I didn't realize bamboo grows pretty darn tall. We got into this forest and it was probably 8 feet, 9 feet tall. And it blocks out the sun. It literally, they had to cut a path to get through the forest because it was so dense. You couldn't leave the path. You had to abide by the path because, unless you had a machete, but it was so dense and it was so dark. So that's where we kind of, we had fun with it as we adventured through the bamboo forest. It got deeper and deeper, it got darker and darker. We started talking about maybe flying monkeys in there, or who knows what was gonna happen when we got in the middle of that. But we finally got through that. And as we broke through the bamboo forest, there it was, 100-foot waterfall, just like in the picture, cascading down, this beautiful pool of water. And we just felt so content and complete with our journey as we sat there, amazed, looking at the waterfall. And that's how I got my wife to fall in love with me, taking her on that trip.
Yeah.
Thank you.